guys, welcome to this video on congruent objects. What happens when I take this object and I flip it? It looks pretty different, right? But aren't all the sides still the same? If I flip it back, we can clearly see that the two objects are the same. This is what we call congruent objects, shapes that can be flipped, turned, slid to make the same shape. All the sides of each shape must be identical. There are a few different ways you can move congruent objects. Moving the object using one of these three movements may change the position or the way that the shape looks, but the shape itself will always remain the same. The first movement we will talk about is a rotation. One way you can move a congruent shape is by turning it or rotating it. The second movement is a reflection. A reflection happens when an object is flipped across an imaginary line or axis. It's almost as if an object is looking at itself in the mirror. The third and the final movement is a translation. A translation happens when you move a shape by simply sliding it in any direction. So you're not turning it or flipping it, you're just sliding it. Okay, now it's time to take a look. These two triangles are congruent, but they have been flipped across the y-axis, so this is a reflection. It is still the exact same triangle, the only difference is that it's been flipped. These two triangles are congruent as well, but they have been rotated or turned. These two arrows are identical in shape and size, so we know that they are congruent. However, they have been slid upwards. This movement is a translation. Okay, now it's your turn to practice. Identify if the following shapes are congruent or not. If they're congruent, then identify how they have been moved by reflection, rotation, or translation. Are these two shapes congruent? No, they're not congruent. We can see that they are different sizes, and one star has 6 points while the other one has 5. To see this more clearly, we can place them on top of one another. Are these two shapes congruent? Yeah, we can see that they are identical. However, they've been moved. What type of movement is this? Well, it looks like they were just flipped, right? If we imagine that there is a line through the middle, we can see that they have been flipped across that line. This shape has been reflected. Are these two shapes congruent? No, we can see that they are different sizes by placing them on top of one another. Okay, last one. Are these two shapes congruent? Yeah. They are identical in shape and size, but what type of movement has been made? Was it flipped like the last one? No, it's not a reflection. Has it been turned or rotated? No, so it's not a rotation. Has it been slid? Yes. So we know that this is a translation.